Good evening. I am Eric Cassion, student body president. Please join me for the Pledge of Allegiance and the National Anthem. Please stand. Put your hand over your heart. Ready, begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please welcome Hernan Torres to the stage.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land
Portillo, and it has been my pleasure to serve as your senior class vice president for graduating class of 22. I would like to welcome all the parents, relatives, and friends of the irreplaceables. I know that this is a very special event for all of us. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the class, the staff of Arleta High School, and especially all the parents for their support. Without all of you, this night may not have been possible. I would now like to introduce student body president, Eric Cassion, to serve as your senior class vice president. Thank you for graduating class of 22. I would like to welcome all the parents, relatives, and friends.
Hello, everyone. I have finally dreamed for this moment and proudly say that we are here today enjoying and realizing the moments we had at school are finally coming to a formal closing. We started our journey in Arleta as children not knowing how fast our time would come. And now we have grown up to the end as adults to finally set off into the real world. Every single one of us here today and those we have lost have made our mentors and those who truly believed in us proud. These past 4 years have made me thankful for the time everyone finally got to enjoy with their friends and teachers in person. COVID has struck us in our sophomore year, and many of us have been glad thinking it would only be 2 weeks. But we were proven wrong, because life had instead severed our ties to our friends and peers and caused previous classes to lose the memories they should have also enjoyed. We will never get that year back, but we persevered as a class and as a family, and we're finally able to see each other, our teachers, and meet new friends along the way. Since freshman year, we've been told to enjoy the time we would get because it would soon fly by. But now we are here standing, saying goodbye to high school and welcoming the real world and its challenges we will soon face. Time is a blessing and a curse that we can never get back, but the time we use together can write the stories that can never be replaced. Our class name, being the Irreplaceables, has a greater meaning than just a class motto. The memories we have made together, whether it be with friends and family and mentors, are truly irreplaceable because we can always come back to those memories to make us feel better. Everyone has struggled in their own ways, and these struggles have made us who we are, because today, everything we have gone through finally pays off. Our senior motto, "Some have a story, but we made history," relates to us because we have endured a part of history, but now we will be writing history because we're finally entering into the real world and making the change we want to see. The stories we have read and heard and witnessed will soon come to life through us because we soon will be the new leaders of this world. And I know that each of us will follow the path that is made for us and make ourselves proud with what we want to do with our lives. I thank every single one of you for being here today, and hope we can enjoy our final moment together, being the class of 22. Please welcome Alexis Nava to the stage. Hello and good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, parents, teachers, and students. Today is an exciting day for all of us, and it is my honor to welcome you all to the Arleta High School Social Justice graduation for the class of 2022. Now, I don't know if you guys all know me, but my name is Alexis Nava. We went to high school together. I'd like to start off and congratulate everyone who is here today. 4 years ago, we all walked into this school confused, scared, and nervous, not knowing what we were getting into. We each took our own different path, and although each path included its own up and down, we all managed to overcome each and every one of them and reach the same destination, which is why we are all here today. There is one story that I always like to tell when talking about my 4 years in high school that I think is important for me to tell today. Everyone always seems to tell us to enjoy our young years in high school because time goes by fast. We never seem to believe this though, because 4 years seems like a long time to us kids. As I stand here today, I think everyone along with myself can agree that we were wrong. Yes, parents, you were right, like always. Okay, now on to the story. The first day of freshman year, my friend and I were waiting in line to get lunch. As we were in line, we were looking at all the seniors in shock, and my friend told me, imagine when that is us making line in 4 years. It always hits me when I remember that, because it seems like he told me that just yesterday. It seems like I became a senior in the blink of an eye. Now, I would like to give a huge thanks to Arleta High School and all the teachers and staff members that have made this possible for us. I would like to start off by saying thanks to the teachers for not only teaching us what we now know, but for also not giving up on us, especially in times where we made the teaching hard. I'd like to thank them for also handling an advisory class, and particularly mine. Hey, Miss. You dealt with us for all 4 years and had no way of escaping us. Even with that, you guys managed to get through and control our class to get what we needed to be done. And without you guys, we wouldn't have been able to complete our portfolio and sit here today. I would now like to go on to the deans, staff, and lunch ladies. From the people in the office to the ones outside of campus. These people all helped the school run properly and made it easy for us to go through our day as smoothly as possible. They each played their own role, which came together to make these years great. So I give a special thanks to them. Now, our principal. Few thanks to him for not just helping us, but also being like a friend. You were there when we needed it, and your excitement made every activity better. Especially the senior picnic, where you ran the bases, and well, you know what happened when you got to third base. It was a great time for everyone being able to have a principal who not only gets things done, but is willing to have a great relationship with the students. Big thanks to you. I would like to end off by mentioning that every single one of us should be proud of ourselves for overcoming all the challenges needed to be here today. We, in particular, had COVID get in our way. We had to leave school for more than a year and do everything online. Although it was tough and everything was harder, every single one of us was able to overcome it. This is something that not everyone will be able to say when thinking about back their high school years. Some have a story, but we made history. So let's all give ourselves a congratulations because we are here and we made it. We are the irreplaceables. Finally, I feel like I thank everyone, but the most important people. I want to give a huge thanks to all the parents here today, especially my mom and dad. Without you guys, we would never be in this position. Mom, thank you for being up on me and making sure I was always doing my best. If I was ever struggling or doing bad, you took time out of your day to help me. You were strict to me, but that is what helped me the most. Although I did not like you sometimes and I thought you were a bit too strict, I now realize that it helped me a lot and would like to thank you for being like that. You pushing me to have a goal to aim for, and now I'm here giving this speech thanks to you. Thank you, Mom, thank you, Dad, and thank you to all the parents here today. We couldn't have done it without you guys. Thank you guys for your time to listen to my speech, and I wish every single one of you guys luck in the future with school and everything that comes your way. Thank you, Arleta High School, and everyone who is part of this school. These have been some awesome 4 years. Congratulations, Class of 2022. Here we go. Thank you.
Mr. Jonathan Hayes, Principal. It is my pleasure to present you the candidates for graduation, the Irreplaceables, Class of 2022.
Okay, Brianna, it is my pleasure to accept the graduating class of 2021. Irreplaceables, you guys are about to leave me, and so I wanted to do a song for you of my way and show you some memories that we've had at the same time.
Irreplaceables.
You did it your way. What is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has enough to say the things he truly feels, and not the words of a one who lives. The record shows. Hello, parents, relatives, friends, and the class of 22 of the Irreplaceables. I'm Jonathan Hayes, principal of Arleta High School. This year is special, and you have made history. The music should be there, just low. Hello, class of 2022. This year is special, and you've made history as the first emerging in-person graduating class where masks are optional since our introduction to the COVID-19 pandemic. Class of 22, you have demonstrated that you have earned the titles of being called effective communicators, critical thinkers, community contributors, and self-directed learners. You have mastered these qualities, and now you are ready to apply them as you make your mark on society and on the future. You gathered your strength to reestablish a sense of normalcy in this world. We did not allow ourselves to be either defined or defeated by COVID-19. Instead, here we are today, creating new memories filled with life, with joy, with love, and most of all, with the Mustang spirit. Mustang graduates, the Irreplaceables, you have been the love of my life. And I want to thank you for your zest. You have adapted, persevered, to emerge as the irreplaceable. So what does it mean to be irreplaceable? Irreplaceable is defined as something that, if lost or damaged, cannot be replaced. It's something that is unique, unrepeatable, priceless, invaluable, beyond price, treasured, prized, and you are cherished. The Mustang spirit is resilient, life, we'll go on. To the senior class of 2022, the Irreplaceables, the world is your stage. Create a future of irreplaceable hope, irreplaceable joy, irreplaceable inspiration, irreplaceable success, and most of all, irreplaceable love. You will continue to thrive, you will achieve, you will aspire, you will succeed, you will adapt to every situation that is placed in front of you. I commend you for your efforts and for your resilience. The human spirit will triumph, and the Mustang spirit is free. I am proud to say that the Arleta High School Mustangs did their part to combat this pandemic. You buckled down, you continued to learn, and today you are graduating. You did it all, and you did it your way, which is why I wanted to do my way for you. This experience is locked in time and therefore is irreplaceable. Your voices are the voices and the visions that will bring a positive change to our collective societies. As you become the doctors, when you become the lawyers, as you become the politicians, as you become the leaders of this great country that we live in, the United States of America. Irreplaceable class of 2022, You have made Arleta High School proud. The Irreplaceables has produced 61 in your class. There are 61 silver seal bearers. Now, what is a silver seal bearer? That means that your grade point average is between 3.0 and 3.59. If you are a silver seal bearer, would you please stand for a minute? You should know who you are. Please stand. You can turn around and wave if you want. Thank you. Have a seat. The Irreplaceables have also produced 26 gold seal bearers. Now, a gold seal bearer has a 3.6 and higher GPA, meaning they have passed all of their classes with more than a B plus or A's. We have 26 of those. If you are a gold seal bearer, will you please stand? All right, let me wait to the audience. Thank you. Mustang, you have made us proud and we respect your accomplishments. You may also note, audience, that many of the graduates are wearing different cards of different colors. The medallions and the cards represent other areas of outstanding accomplishments and awards that these students have received during their years of study here at Arleta High School. The class of 2022 has 19 superintendent honor roll recipients. If you are a superintendent honor roll recipient, you have a GPA of 3.8 or higher, and you passed all of your A through G requirements. If you are a superintendent honor roll recipient, will you please stand if you're here? Any superintendent honor roll? All right. You are to be commended. High honors. Thank you. Also, there is another class. These are called persistent award recipients. That means that somewhere in their career, they had an obstacle. They had a challenge. However, they overcame it. They buckled down. They reserved themselves. They went to whatever they had to do to be here today. And there are 44 of those. If you are a persistent award recipient, will you please stand? Thank you so much. And I'm going to deviate. I want you to always understand that the game is not over until it's over. And these recipients, they stuck in there and they fought it out. Okay? Arleta High School has three small learning communities. We have SMART, we have Social Justice, which you are, and we have NAPA, who graduated earlier today. Each small learning community has chosen a student that exemplifies who they are and represents them. Social Justice has chose Eric Cincion. NAPA chose Brandon Cooper, and SMART chose Christian C. The highest honor bestowed on any high school environment is that of valedictorian. And today we have four valedictorians. That means that they have a GPA of 4.0 or higher, which means they've never gotten a grade less than an A in any class that they've taken. The valedictorians are spread out through the different SOCs, but number one valedictorian in the school is Christian C. If you're here, Christian, no, he's in SMART, so his GPA is 4.425. He's going to go to UCLA. Rebecca Calderon has a GPA of 4.272. Rebecca is going to UC in San Diego. Is that correct, Rebecca? Stand up and wave at them one more time. Hey! Okay. Thank you. And then Brenda Armas. Has a GPA of 4.183, and she will be going to CSU at Long Beach. And the last valedictorian is Pamela Aguilar, who has a GPA of 4.081, and who will be attending CISA. Arleta High School and the Replaceables, the class of 22, we are indebted to you. Class of 22, I would now like to change and talk to you directly, you know, as your principal and as your friend. As you go forward in this world, I charge you to be a light to others that you meet in the dark. Don't give up if the road gets rocky. Apply yourself and use your irreplaceable nature to overcome again and again. Dream big and achieve your goals. Climb every mountain. Use all of your gifts to make the world a better place. Leave your imprint of generosity, servitude, integrity, dependability in any and all situations that you may encounter. Some of you are going to be going to college straight, some of you are going to trade schools, and others may be going to a military service. Whatever your avenue, do not be discouraged by setbacks or failures. You have been prepared for this, and you, class of 22, were born for success. You were born to excel, so this is your time. Travel every path, cut a path where others have never gone. Create a vision that you see of the world. Be persistent. We believe in you, class of 22. Your parents behind you, they believe in you. Most of all, I know class of 22, because you are here, you believe in yourself. I know that you believe in yourself and you can never be replaced because you have made history. You're the first mask optional graduating class on the eve of COVID-19. Today, collectively, we are graduating 271 seniors. Some are viewing this from home, and I feel you here in spirit. I hope that being an Arleta Mustang will become one of your most cherished memories, and I hope you will love your VAPA classmates, your SMART classmates, and your social justice classmates, and know that you all will endure. I hope you will continue to count the small things as precious, the small things like a breath of fresh air, the small things like a handshake that we were denied for so long, the small things like being able to hug a friend that we were denied for so long. Most of all, I hope that you will remember the inaugural principle, the first principle, Dr. Linda Calvo's statement that once a Mustang, you will always be a Mustang. And with that being said, now by the power vested in me by the Board of Education of this Los Angeles Unified School District, I declare that the irreplaceables, the class of 22, have met your graduation requirements and that you are now ready to receive your diplomas. Thank you.
Valedictorian Brenda Adamas.
Rona Carillo Bernal. Aileen Cruz Mendez. With honors, Vanessa de la Cruz. Jasmine Farias Martinez. Damian Garcia. With high honors, Leilani Enriquez. Dylan Hernandez. Elias Ibarra. Paola Lana Verde. With honors, Brian Martinez. With honors, Allison Martinez. Valerie Navarro. With honors, Dalia Rios. David Salas. Manuel Salazar. With high honors, Emma Sepulveda. Mariani Espinosa Sierra. Now introducing Mr. Garcia, advisory. Yahaira Alondra Aleman. With honors, Daniela Giselle Avila. Ivania Nicole Bolanos. Roxana Betzabet Borunda. Joey Carrillo. Gabby de la Rosa. Chris Diaz. With high honors, Jarenka Flores. Juan Jimenez. Thank you. with high honors, Sara Loma. With honors, Samira Ochoa Gonzalez. Hilda Vanessa Quintanilla. Ramirez. With high honors, Jared Rivas. Rodriguez. With honors, Jocelyn Alessandra Rodriguez Tejeda. With high honors, Ranky Swan. Jaylee Rosalie Castellon. Angel Avendano Cordosa. Now introducing Ms. Harris Advisory. Thank you. Ryan Andrade. With honors, Valeria Bernal Reyes. With honors, Isaac Campos. Anthony Carrillo. With high honors, Yesenia Casillas Rios. María Guadalupe Contreras. Kaylin Fabian. Cesar Figueroa. Dorian Garcia. With honors, Justin Guardado Alvarado. Sofia Michelle Harin. Alondra Mariscal. Carlo Martín del Campo. Leonardo Mendoza Aravelo. With honors, Haley Miranda. April Moran. Natalie Perez. Johan Plata. Thomas. Introducing Mr. Richards Advisory. Alfaro Sepúlveda. Jonathan Ansaldo Valenzuela. Ciclali Esmeralda Baez. Kimberly Castillo Irazo. Tania Catarino. With honors, Agustin de los Santos Medrano. With honors, Michelle Dominguez Arzate. With honors, Edgar Hernandez Solano. Stephanie Areli Martinez. With high honors, Guadalupe Martinez Martinez. With high honors, Pablo Panduro Torres. Pablo Rodriguez. Daisy Rodriguez Gabriel. With honors, Eric Sencion. Jocelyn Tejeda. Rumi Vasquez. Abraham Villalobos Saucedo. Jose Zuniga Maya. Now introducing Ms. Solis Advisory. Oh. Catalina Paeza Ortiz. David Becerra. Ballet Victorian Rebecca Elizabeth Calderon. Alan Cruz Quiroz. Jaime Fernandez. Johnny Garcia. Sofia Guadalupe Ignacio. With honors, Gabriela Magallanes. Mejia. With honors, Otoniel Mendoza González. Mariah Janae Perez. Yeah. Juan Ponititananon. With honors. As my last official act as class vice president, I accept these diplomas for the class of 2022.
The irreplaceables, please join me in moving your tassels from the right to the left. Congratulations, the irreplaceables class of 2022!
Thank you.